May the Lord honor everything that concerns you in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm reading from Proverbs chapter 15 and verse number 33 this day. The fear of the Lord is the instruction of wisdom, and before honor is humility. It's our month of honor, and thank God for those powerful scriptures yesterday in the book of Psalm chapter 91, verse number 15. It said, call on me and I will answer. I will be with you in trouble. I will deliver you and I will honor you. Those five steps to honor was absolutely powerful yesterday. Thank God for that scripture. But today, we're going to begin to consider, what does it take for God to honor you? Yesterday, we saw that calling upon the Lord will place you for honor. But that's not enough. There's something else, according to the scripture we just read today, that is most fundamental if you want God to honor you. And that scripture said, the fear of the Lord is the instruction of wisdom. So you must fear the Lord. You must reference the Lord. You must have regard to the things of the Lord if you desire the wisdom of God. But more importantly, it is summed up in this line, before honor is humility. The two of them start with H, and I couldn't understand why, but the fact is simple. One cannot come without the other, meaning you can never enjoy God's honor until you become humble. Humility is a vital virtue in God's kingdom. If you are not humble, you cannot be saved. If you are not humble, you cannot be healed if you are sick. If you are not humble, God cannot deliver you. God cannot do anything for a proud man. In fact, the Bible says God resists the proud. So once pride is found in you, God automatically becomes your enemy. That is not what anyone or where anyone wants to find themselves, where God becomes the one who's resisting your progress, resisting your promotion. He said, God resists the proud. But in the other way around, he gives grace to the humble. I'm reading 1 Peter chapter 5, verse number 6. Humble yourself, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. Not whenever situation humbles you, it becomes humiliation. Humility is what you make up your mind on your own and decide under God to operate by. You must be humble in everything. God wants you to be humble in your look, humble in your talk, humble in the way you carry yourself. The explanation of the dictionary on humility talks about being modest. You know, low estate of self, of one's importance. Not feeling too important. Not feeling that you are too big for anything in God. So that scripture says, humble yourself. So it's you that will humble yourself, therefore, before the mighty hand of God. If God humble a man, he will turn you to powder. You will become nothing. God cannot, in fact, for God to humble you, it means he will humiliate you. We saw that in a king in the Bible, whom God sent to the bush to go and eat with the grasses in order to humble him. God cannot help a proud man, except the man learn to humble himself. Most of the problem we have in our society is the problem of pride. Pride of life, pride of your whatever you are, pride of whosoever you think you are. For you to enjoy honor, you must learn how to humble yourself. And that scripture said, it will now bring your being exalted. God will lift you up in your due time. So I want to speak on one way to help yourself become humble. Humility is seen in one most very vital way when you are corrected. Either somebody who is higher than you correcting you, or your mates correcting you, or the people who are lower than you, who are not in the same, correcting you. Life is all about correction, and it's the biggest gift in the world. When pride takes over, you're going to see correction as somebody cursing you. I've heard that. Why are you cursing me? Because all you were doing is to correct the person, and the person gets angry the more that you are embarrassing them. Whenever correction becomes an embarrassment, humility is off the roof. And the fact is, it is not possible if you position yourself with the people in your life that a whole full 24 hour will go without something somewhere is positioned to ask as correction. You know, to correct you in the way you do things, in the way you talk, in the way you act and behave around your loved ones at home. Whenever people begin to point to you that, do you think this, your reaction at that time is what determines if pride is already taking over. Pride is not anybody's name, but it's very sneaky. It will come in a way that you begin to make yourself feel too important for anybody to talk to you or to talk against you or to tell you where you are wrong. Meanwhile, like I said years ago, correction is a gift. Everyone who corrects you loves you. In fact, the scripture said, it is the child that a father loves, he corrects. So God positioned people, mentor, friends, your junior ones, and they will say, ah, this thing is not good. The way you, at that time, you should be able to catch yourself. If you find that you get irritated, you get angry, and you want to answer as if, how can you say that? Immediately check yourself and ask yourself, I'm getting proud. Of course, pride is like something that begins little. And when you keep feeding it, it keeps rising. So is humility. Humility begins with little way of knowing that, okay, oh, thank you for telling me that, thank you. Once you begin to see correction as improvement to your personality, humility will begin to expand. And don't forget what the scripture is saying. God cannot honor you except you are humble. So if there's a daily work to do, it's a work to learn how to be humble. Relationship is about humility. Thousands of relationships are dying every day, either marriage relationship or work relationship or family relationship, because people do not understand that humility is a virtue. I want to encourage you that this new month, you make a target to get humble the more, to humble yourself before the Lord so that God can raise you up. Because before honor is humility. I like you to write it there and say it louder. Before honor is humility, meaning you must be humble in order for God to honor you. I scream and I say, this is your month of honor. You will enjoy honor as you make yourself humble in Jesus' name.